some little snack to go with it. And it's going to be a stout beer, a blueberry stout. And so I'm going to eat some small little individual candies, chocolate candies. I thought would go good with that, with their little wrappers, for anyone that likes those sounds. And then we would also do a review of a game that I love and I highly recommend. And we'll play a little game, you and I. Does that sound pretty cool? The best we can do, right? It's called Munchkin by Steve Jackson Games. Steve Jackson, if you're not familiar with, was one of the people up. Yeah, people. I was going to say persons. One of the person peoples to work and develop Dungeons & Dragons, Advanced Dungeons & Dragons. I'm not sure how he was involved or what role he played, but there's a ton of these games out. This is a card game, and basically it pokes fun at Dungeons and Dragons role-playing types of games by having a little fun with the different names of spells, characters, classes, and monsters, and such. And there's different themes of this game. Cthulhu Munchkin, Pirate Munchkin, Zombie Munchkin, which I also have. I also need to get Cthulhu Munchkin. And basically, you assume the role of a character. You get cards that enhance your character. You fight monsters. It's like a little bit of a trading card game, except you don't really trade the cards. They don't come out in booster packs. You get everything in this one box. So, it's a really fun game. I highly recommend it. So we're going to do a little bit of a tutorial, show you some of the cards, and have some fun with that. Sound good? All right, cool. All right, well, let me get the beer that we are going to review. And as I mentioned, it is called Trace Blueberry Stout. Just a 7.5% ABV, and doesn't really say, nothing really fancy about the history of the beer, how they brew it, or anything like that. Sometimes you'll find that on the label, but here, I'm not sure if you can, hopefully you can make it out. There's some little purple blueberry splotches on the design of the label. And a Dark Horse Brewing Company logo at the top there. The camera wants to focus on my face, which is kind of scary. But anyway, it's not working. So we are going to open that. And of course, before we do, we have to get our exercise in. So if you can, grab your bottle opener if you got one like this. And just repeat after me. One. There's three others, which I don't really know offhand, but it's a fairly reasonable priced set, and they're really very well made. Very well made glasses. So again, if you're, you know, looking to add a little something to your glassware, you don't really have any beer types of glasses, it might be something you want to check out. Just wanted to bring that up again. Okay, so let's get on with the beer review first. Might be the best pour I have done to date. Not much head on the beer because you're not going to hear too much fizz because I kind of kept it on the angle the whole time. So, but as far as not, you know, that was kind of, well, maybe it wasn't the best pour yet, so there's nothing really for you to hear. But you can see it's very dark. Looks black there. It just, yeah, it's dark, dark brown. Almost, the camera makes it look black, but let's see what. Wow. I can definitely smell the blueberry. And of course, that typical malty stout aroma. Yeah, that's blueberry in there. Let's give this a taste. Well, smooth. A nice stout. It's smooth, not bitter. Got that great malt flavor. Has more of a stronger aroma than the taste. There's a nice hint of blueberry in the taste, but it's not like the chocolate stout that I had. As far as flavored beers, I have to say, chocolate stout had more of a chocolate flavor, pronounced chocolate, you know, strong chocolate flavor, strong chocolate flavor, you know, it's pretty strong. But this blueberry, it has a good blueberry, like almost like blueberry muffin. Maybe my blueberry taste buds are dead. as far as a blueberry stout or a flavored beer, I would say 2.5 aroma gives it, you know, the high 2.5, 3 for being a blueberry aroma aromatic beer. But as far as like tasting blueberry, I'm just not feeling that or tasting it. But a good beer anyway. Oh, and my apologies. It's not too late. Cheers. Cheers. Cling. Whatever you're drinking, as always, whenever I do these reviews, you don't have to be a beer drinker. It's really just me trying to enjoy different beers, hang out with you, drink whatever you like. Don't drink, you know, have a beer, have wine, have fruit beer. You know, it's all good. As long as you get to hang out, you know. Sorry, so we got the beer review out of the way. Well, why don't we take, Munchkin game. Take the beer. Take some of the little tasty. I got some peanut butter egg here and a little chocolate caramel cookie candy here. A couple of those that I'll probably snack on a little bit as we do the Munchkin. I was thinking about doing the Munchkin tutorial all by itself, just to make that the main focus, but, you know, we're doing it this way. So, alright, well, let's head over to my little game table, shall we, and check out the game of Munchkin. Dismemberment. Start by slaughtering the potted plant mix and match them for a completely silly dungeon crawl. So yeah, so when you purchase a game of Munchkin, you get all the cards for that particular version or set. There's no booster packs, but to expand or to get the different kinds of artwork and items and monsters, you have to buy each different set, and they are about $25 each box. So there's over two different Munchkin sequels, supplements, so you can, it's a little bit of an investment, but if you're a fan of the game and support companies like this, you know, it's what Steve Jackson and company have done for the gaming world. You know, it's definitely a nice alternative. Definitely need to get, there's Cthulhu Munchkin. I have Zombie Munchkin, which I'll do a video on next. Not long after this one, I want to get back to doing more of these videos. And there is also like Pirate Munchkin and things like that. So it also says here on the bottom, Joking Hazard, small parts. That's because of the die. 3 to 6 players, 1 to 2 hours, 10 and up. Not for kids, 0 to 3. That's just a disclaimer, really, because of the die. But we were playing with our son when he was 4, and I'm pretty sure I bought this when he was 3. Could have been when he was 4, but he's been playing when he was 4. I think 4, yeah. And before we played Pokemon, and he really enjoys this. So, I mean, he can play pretty much the whole thing. He can't really remember some of the complex aspects, such as when to, you know, use his character, classes, perk to do a certain action, or sell some of his items to level up, which you can do. He plays a real kind of a more basic version of it, but he can play. So, why don't we check out the inside. Of course, we have the manual, and it's quite large, but it's not very complicated. If you're a gamer, it's not going to be that difficult. Once you play through a couple games, it looks like it's a lot to it. It's really not that bad at all. And they leave a lot of room for you to, they leave a lot of leeway, so the instructions aren't very, the rules aren't very stringent. We're not really going to go through the rules too much. I might, but I really want to just go through the game, because the video is going to be long enough as it is, showing you the different cards and how to play. I don't really want to have to go through and read this as much as I would love to. I'll basically go through it, and then of course maybe, you know, we'll just play some sample games, and then if you really want to get more involved and in depth, you know, I just recommend go, you know, buying the game if you like what you see. Here's the die. Yeah, there's the number 1, and of course it's just a nice little, who doesn't love dice, right? Die. Here's all the different cards. There's 168 cards in here. And like I said, I'm just going to go through here and show you how to play, give you an overview. We'll do a quick little session. Well, not a quick little session, but we'll just do a me and you pretend we're playing together, okay? If that's cool with you. Alright, so here's how the game works. I don't really have a counter with me to keep track of level 1. Everybody that's playing starts off as a level 1 human. And as you draw cards, there'll be classes, races, items, spells, things like that, that will enhance your level 1 character. They'll help you go up a level. You can sell items to go up a level. And of course, defeat monsters to go up a level. So, that's really basic. That's it. You, whoever whoever gets to level 10 first is the winner. Alright, so here's the deck of cards. We have door cards, and basically how you, instead of having a map, this is like your dungeon, right here, all in one deck. And this is your treasure, all in one deck. And what you do is you basically knock down a door, which means you flip, you draw a card, flip it over, and see what you have here. You see? A mall rat. A creature from hell. +3 against the clerics. Bad stuff. She whacks you. Lose a level. So that means if you can't defeat her, she's level 1. You need to be, your level plus any items and bonuses that you have to be greater than the monster's level. But for some reason you can't beat this monster, you basically, you know, you would probably just be level 1. So you would just, anything would happen to you, you would start at level 1 again. But that's an example. You knock down a door, it could be a curse, it could be anything, it could be just a regular card, a dwarf, or a race, it could be a monster, it could be a curse, lose a level. So that's what you basically, you do. Everybody takes a turn, you knock down the door, that's like the room that you're going into the dungeon. You knock down the room, you open the door, see what's in that room to fight. It's a monster, it's something that enhances your character. If it's not a monster, you get to draw, you get to loot the room. You basically draw another card, and keep that in your hand. Or maybe it's an item or something. Basically, you didn't fight a monster. So we'll do all that. And the treasure cards are only when you defeat a monster. You, treasure cards, items and spells and things like that. Alright, so basically how you start is each player gets 4 cards from each deck. So, this will be your cards, and we'll show you all those. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and we'll just keep the decks like over here somewhere. And then we got 1, 2, 3, 4. Alright, so why don't we just line up the cards here and see what we got. And basically you can only have 5 cards in your hand. Any cards that describe your race, your class, your items, those go in play, and those would go down on the gaming board so everyone can see. So here I have an item. It's a potion. I'm sorry. It's a potion of confusion. A potion of confusion. Used during any combat, +3 to either side. That means you can use it to enhance a monster, to make it difficult for someone to fight their monster, make it difficult for them to rise up in level, of course, making it more difficult for them to win the game. Or you can use it for you, to enhance your abilities to defeat the monster. So that's an item. I'll put that in play. I have spiky knees. Just a piece of armor, spiky knees. It's a +1 bonus. And how you fight monsters is you take your level, any bonuses from cards such as this, you add them together, and that's basically your power. And if that's greater than the level of the monster that you're fighting, you defeat the monster. That's it. That's all there is to it. So if I was level 1 and I had these spiky knees, which I do, I'm now power of 2. So if I get a level 1 monster, I defeat it. And of course, down at the bottom it says 200 gold pieces. So if I sell enough items to total 1,000 gold pieces, I go up a level as well. So I can play that, put that in play. Here's a magic lamp, another item. You may use the lamp only on your turn. It summons a genie who makes a single monster vanish, even if you had already failed your runaway roll and it was about to catch you. If it was the only monster you were facing, you may take its treasure, but you don't gain a level. ask for help normally and gets the treasure in levels if he wins. The original player then resumes his turn and may loot the room, whether the combat was won or lost. Usable only once. So, basically, if you're fighting a monster, or if someone else is fighting you monster, and you want that monster to fight someone else, you use this, that other else person has to fight, and it could be, you know, difficult for them to fight them. And of course, again, it's making the, it's part of the game, making it difficult for other people to rise up in level. Alright, next card I have is a race card, Dwarf. You can carry any number of big items. You can have 6 cards in your hand besides 5. So it's a card that gives you 2 perks. You can carry any number of big items, and big items are like two-handed items. It'll say actually big item on the card. Normally you can only carry 1, but this lets you carry any number. So that will be my race. You can only have 1 race card. Here is a curse card. Lose a level. Because I'm starting with this, this curse card does not affect me. But if I was to draw it when I knock down the door over here, I would be cursed and lose a level. Instead, I have this in my hand. I can play this to curse someone else. And make them lose a level. So that works for me. So that goes in my hand, because it's not really an item or that I would carry. Here's a class card, Cleric. He has 2 perks, Resurrection. When it is time for you to draw cards face up, you may instead take some or all from the top of the appropriate discard pile. You must then discard 1 card from your hand for each card so drawn. Turning, you may discard up to 3 cards in combat against an undead creature. Each discard gives you a +3 bonus. So I'll be a dwarf cleric. Enraged, +5 to monster. Play during combat. If the monster is defeated, draw 1 extra treasure. So again, I can play this to make someone else's life miserable. It gives a +5 power to a monster, or I can do it for me, my own monster. If I know I'm going to easily defeat him, I get an extra treasure. So that goes in my hand, and there's the curse. So I'll just put these in my hand, and I'll just put my hand over here. Now let's check out your cards, okay? Here's all 8 cards that I drew for you. Chicken on your head. -1 to all your die rolls, and really when you roll the die that you get with the game, right there, it's just to run away, whether you succeed in running away. Any curse or bad stuff that removes your headgear will take the chicken with it. There's also a wishing ring, which will remove curses, so you have that, you can curse me with that. So that will go in your hand. You have a level 1 monster, a Maul Rat. M-A-U-L. It's got a big hammer there. A creature from hell, +3 against the clerics. Bad stuff, she whacks you, lose a level. So if you can't fight this creature for whatever reason, if you're level 1 and you have no items that will give you a +1 power, so that you're power is 2, which would defeat this, then if you were to fight this monster, you would lose. It would do bad stuff to you, as indicated here, which means you would lose a level, but basically you would just start at level 1, and that's really it. So I don't it's just kind of funny. So that would go in your hand. Another monster, a net troll. He has no special powers, and he's really mad about it. Bad stuff screws up the game balance by forcing you to let the players of the highest level take any 1 item each from you. 3 treasures if Harris's Three Treasures. That's how many treasures you get if you defeat this one. And of course the bad stuff, if you can't fight him and you run away, that's the stuff that he'll do to you if you miss your runaway roll. So that goes in your hand. Half-breed. You may have two race cards and have all the advantages and disadvantages of each. Or you may have one race card and have all of its advantages and none of its disadvantages. For example, monsters that hate elves will have no bonus against a half-elf. Lose this card if you lose your race cards, so you can be a half-breed. That will go in your play hand. Here's an item. Pantyhose of Giant Strength. +3 bonus. Remember, the bonus gets added to your level for your total power. And that total power is compared against the monster's level. And if the total power, if your total power is greater than the monster's level, you defeat the monster and get its treasures. Not usable by a warrior. Because a warrior, of course, would not use a pantyhose. That's just common sense. Down at the bottom, you can see it says 600 gold pieces. If you trade in items, discard items worth 1,000 gold pieces, you go up one level. So that's an item that you can wear. Knee pads of Allure. No player with a level higher than yours can refuse your request for help against a monster, or even ask for a reward. You cannot gain the winning level in a combat where your helper was compelled by the knee pads. So, you can ask for help, but you can't gain the winning level. You won't go up a level, but it helps you from having to try to roll away, do a die roll to run away, and possibly get killed by a monster and lose a lot of stuff. So, but not usable by a cleric. So you're not a cleric, so you can use those knee pads of Allure. Horny Helmet. +1 bonus. +3 for elves. It's a headgear. You can only have one type of headgear, you know, at a time. 600 gold pieces, so you can wear that. You have no other headgear. And here is Slimy Armor. This is my son's favorite. +1 bonus. It's got some kind of whale or fish thing on the top as a decoration or something. It's armor, and you can only have one armor type, so you can wear that. So let's see what you have. A horny helmet gives you a +1 bonus. You're not an elf, so you only get that +1. You're not a warrior, so you can use the pantyhose of giant strength, and it gives you a +3 bonus. And you have slimy armor, +1 bonus, so 1 plus 3 is 4, plus 1 is 5. You're level 1, so you have a power of 6. So you can defeat any monster that's level 5 or less. And then for me, I have just the +1 bonus of spiky knees. So I would just get a power of +2, +1. For the bonus from the spiky knees, and my level is 1, so that's +2 power, so I can defeat any monster that's level 1. Alright, so that's your hand, my hand, and good luck. Alright, so you can knock down the door first, and this is how we basically play. You knock down the door, and basically draw a card, and you get a thief card. It's a class card. It's backstabbing. You may discard a card to backstab another player. You may do this only once per victim per combat. But if two players are fighting a monster together, you may backstab each of them. So when you backstab them, it gives them a -2 in combat. So it makes them more difficult. You're basically hurting them. It takes away 2 from their overall power. It makes it more difficult for them to fight a monster. But you have to discard a card to do it. So you gotta, determine when it's small item carried by another player. Roll a die. 4 or more succeeds. Otherwise, you get whacked and lose a level. You get caught. So, that's a class card. And you don't have any other class cards. So, you can be a thief. In your hand, if you have any monsters that you, after you knock down the door, basically, you know, as you go through the dungeon knocking down doors and see what's in different rooms, if there's no monster that you fight, you can see if you have any monsters in your hand that you think you can fight. And you do. You have the level 1 mall rat, so you can fight that. I could make it difficult for you by throwing in my potion of confusion, which has a +3 to either side during combat. It will give the mall rat become a +4, but you still have your bonuses. 1 + 3 = 4, +1 = 5, +6. So that's not really going to do much. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to keep that. And if nobody else does anything to you, oh, I'm sorry, I actually have here enraged +5 to monster. So I will do that, make that mall rat enraged. It's now 6. You have your level of 1. Again, plus your bonuses of 5, that's 6. You don't have enough to defeat the mall rat. You need to have 7. Don't really have anything else that can help you. So now you have to roll. So let's just roll the die on something that's a little bit quiet, and you have to get a 5 or 6 to run away. And you do. So you run away. And you don't get the treasure from the mall rat. The mall rat didn't do bad stuff to you, which would cause you to lose a level. But you're already level 1. You can't go down to level 0, so it wouldn't really do anything much to you anyway. And then we just discard those in a discard pile. And that is your turn. Your turn is over. But maybe you have this curse card. Any curse cards that you have, you can play anytime. So because I kind of made the game difficult for you, but, you know, you don't even have to wait for that. You can just play whenever you feel like it. You curse me. You put a chicken on my head. And it gives me a -1 to all my rolls. So I put that down. Of course, I still have a curse. Lose a level. But I'm not going to use that until you go up a level. Alright, so my turn to draw a card. Knock down the door, and I get a halfling race. And I already have a dwarf race. But the halfling says you may sell 1 item each turn for double price. Other items are at normal price. I can sell 1 item for double, but any other item I sell with it is normal. Also, if I fail my initial runaway roll, I can discard a card and try to roll again. So I'm already a dwarf, but I'm not really going to switch my race. I think you can do that. I have to look into the rules. Okay, so because I didn't find a monster when I knocked down the door, I can loot the room. So I basically pull another door card. And now I have a level 6 Pikachu. It's a monster that apparently vomits on you. You gain an extra level if you defeat it without using help or bonuses. Bad stuff. Projectile vomiting attack. Discard your whole hand. So if you can't fight it and you run away, and you can't run away, it catches you. You have to discard your whole hand. But if you defeat it, you get 2 treasures. Because I drew this as I looted the room, this goes in my hand, so I can play this as a monster. so I can take this out of my hand, put it down into play, fight it, and win and go up a level. Or I might be able to play it on you, make you fight two monsters if I have an appropriate card that will make me do that, which there is. So this will just go in my hand. And again, your hand cards, you would hold just like poker cards. You wouldn't let your opponent see them. Alright, and now it's your turn again. So you you draw a card. And you got a curse card. Lose one big item. Choose one big item to discard. And you don't have any big items. So, I'm not sure if that means you still have to discard something or not, but it says big item, so you don't have any, so I don't think that affects you. You have in your hand a level 10 net troll, but you're only level 1 plus your bonuses of 5, which is 6, so you don't have enough power to defeat him. Again, you would need enough bonuses to add to your level to make... level up to make your power equal 11, because your power needs to be greater than the monster's level. Alright, so I'm just going to take here a moment to enjoy some of this. Take a little snack break if you have a snack. Chocolate and peanut butter. It's that perfect sweet and salt mix. Potion of Panfilia. so I'll draw on, I'll loot the room. And I found Super Munchkin card. You may have two class cards and have all the advantages and disadvantages of each, or one class and none of its disadvantages. I will use Super Munchkin. And I am a cleric, and it says, I can discard up to three cards in combat against an undead creature. Each discard gives you +3 bonus. That's not really a disadvantage. The disadvantage here would be for my resurrection ability. When it is time for you to draw cards face up, you may instead take some or all from the top of the appropriate discard pile. You must then discard one card from your hand for each card so drawn. So basically this means if I have to draw three treasure cards for fighting a monster, instead I could draw three cards from a discard pile. And because I have Super Munchkin, I don't have to worry about discarding one card from my hand for each card that I draw off the discard. So something to keep in mind. I've never really done that. So who knows how that works out. Alright, so we'll try to do this until we get a monster. Why don't we just, we'll go through some of the cards. Curse, lose the foot gear you are wearing. So, whose turn was it last? That was your turn. Was it my turn? I don't know. I'm losing track here. Anyway, I want to get, you get the idea of drawing the cards here. Let me see if I can get a creature in here. Just to give you an idea how the combat works. Let's see what we got in here. There's all kinds of different items. Okay, here we go. Level 4. So let's say you drew these harpies. It's a level 4 harpies. You can see they're playing the harps. They resist magic +5 against wizards. So if you're a wizard, they are now level 9. Bad stuff. Their music is really, really bad. Lose 2 levels. So if you can't fight them and you need to run away and you fail your runaway roll, they'll catch you and you'll lose 2 levels. But let's say you drew that card to fight them. They're level 4. You're still level 1. So level 1 plus a 1 bonus for the horny helmet is a 2 power. Plus 1 bonus for the spiky knees, you now have 3 power. Plus 3 bonus for the pantyhose of giant strength, you now have 6 power. 6 beats. Wait, am I doing that right? Yes. Because you drew a card for me from that curse that I got. So you now have 6 power. That defeats level 4 harpies. And you're not a wizard. So you basically defeat it. You just discard it. And it has 2 treasures. You can see that. So basically you discard that. You would note somewhere on whatever counter system you're using. We use pen and paper, so you would just do 1 plus 1 level for the fighting. Most monsters are just 1 level. So you would now be level 2. Some say 2 levels or something, if they're very powerful. And then you'd get to draw 2 cards from the treasure pile. Now what do we have here? We have a cloak of obscurity, usable by a thief only, and that's you, and it gives you a +4 bonus, so there you go, more power. And you also got a invisibility potion. Use when your runaway roll fails, you escape automatically, usable once only. So it's a way for you to, you can see the little guy here, he's kind of sticking his tongue out at the little orc creature running by. And so that would help you if you fail your runaway roll. You could just use this potion and escape the creature. And whenever you run away from a creature, you don't get its treasures. You just discard it. guess. But all your other items and stuff you would discard, and you would start all over again at level 1. Until next time.